Woo. Hey guys, welcome back to On the Fly. So I was able to talk Allie into bringing out one of my new favorites, the Havoc XE. I fell in love with this plane right in the beginning when you had got your first Havoc, and I actually with
you
the,
mean the
box,
big one, the big turbine.
The big turbine. And you actually allowed me and a couple of the guys to have around a buddy box on it, and it was so sweet, it was so smooth, it was such a nice airplane that to get a smaller one, one that's a little bit more affordable and in foam, that was a really cool thing.
Havoc was the most popular sport jet for the last couple of years. The big one, which everyone saw, which is what you got to fly.
Yeah.
And then came a smaller one, the SS, and then even smaller one, GTS. So it's a natural progression, evolution. We teamed up with Elite and made the Havoc XE, which is what you see here. There's a lot of feedback about the Havoc, rightly so. It literally stopped, you know, crashed our internet almost the day we released it. Back orders have been amazing. But there's been some feedback which has been less than positive and ideal about the claims we made in the marketing spiel, our copy as we call it, about speed and duration.
So that's what I wanted to ask you. So we said 140 miles an hour plus.
Yep.
10-minute flight time. So upwards of 10 minutes and 140 miles an hour. Is that something that we could show them?
That's the idea.
In this video.
I suggest, with no further ado, we make the most of this weather before it turns Illinois on us and rains or wind picks up to 30 mile an hour and start playing.
All right, sounds good.
Cool.
Yeah,
let's go.
So yeah, fresh pack. Came off charge about 10 minutes ago. It'll probably take a couple of runs also to get the pack warm and unloaded, but let's start and see how we get on.
Keep going on about it, but it's all stock equipment. Nothing has been changed on this airplane to make it any way different than what the Havoc the customers would buy.
We're going as near vertical as possible.
Sounds good. Sounds good.
Woo. Okay, do one more of those, I reckon we get out of this pack, but that I felt a lot better with that. Diving in now vertically.
Man, that thing starts whistling. Woo! Yeah, that was a lot closer. I think I missed that
one. All right.
It
sounded cool.
Yeah.
So, moment of truth. All live. No staging of speeds or runs or putting the GPS in a faster system. I'm going to land it. Close and possible. I'm making a bad job of that. I'm excited to see the reading on that.
Yeah.
GPS.
So, moment of truth. What did I say? I wanted 130, right? Anything over 130, I was happy.
I'm not even going to look. I'm going to let you guys look. Ready? What we got?
148.
Boom! Yes!
Beautiful.
Oh, I'm happy with that. 2 miles an hour off 150. 8 miles an hour over our 140 mile an hour stated claim of 140 plus. So yes, I'm happy with that. Getting comments online is the duration statement.
Yeah.
Which was how long?
10 minutes. 10 minutes plus, minutes. I think 12 minutes
12
even.
12 minutes, dude. Yeah.
So, I mean, and that's to say, you know, when you're working for that number, which, you know, it's obviously not a full throttle operation to get that type of flight time.
I've never flown 3 minutes on an EDF,
yeah, right?
12.
Yeah.
That's like four flights.
Mm-hmm. And you haven't gone for a duration flight yet.
True.
Okay, so we bumped up the battery from the 5,000 when we were doing the high-speed runs.
One of the beauties of this airplane, cavernous, huge battery area, so you're not limited. Yeah. So yeah, 7,000 drops straight in.
Perfect. Well,
you
once
got the
again,
timer.
Yeah, and it is out on the runway. Should I start it like from the second you hit the throttle or the second it leaves the ground? What do you think? We might as well.
Yeah, whatever you decide.
Yeah, we're gonna give you the.
I can't see me coming close to 12 minutes, mate. We'll give it a go.
All right.
Ready?
So,
let's see.
3, 2, 1, start. So we're 5 seconds in.
Get away. Half power. Are we done yet?
30 seconds in.
12 minutes? Oh, no, I haven't got 12 minutes of attention span.
All right.
Probably the worst thing I can do, because I know you have to use power to get uphill. See, I'm not meant for this duration. And some arrows, look.
Oh, wow! Oh.
Bit of inverted, roll out. Yeah. Bit of energy management. See how long my focus lasted for. What's the time at?
You're almost 6 minutes.
6 minutes. I nearly made the 6 minutes without flying like an idiot.
You say you're... We're using precious milliamps for those rolls.
This is hard work. This is the hardest flying I've done for a long time. Mandarin's come out now. Look, everyone's come out to see what could possibly go wrong. Hey, Matt.
How you doing?
Not bad. Bored. Well, I lie. I'm bored. Tell me.
Boom. 12:05.
Oh, man.
12-minute flight.
I'm so high up now. I don't think I should come down. Let's go 13. Come on. 13 yet?
10 seconds, we'll be at 13.
I can't land on 13, that's an unlucky number.
Yeah.
Point roll, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Ugliest 4-point roll I've done in a while, but it was a 4-point roll.
Everybody thought we were a little bit overestimating the aircraft.
Not everybody, but it's fair to say, yeah, we read a few comments. And I can see why. They're big numbers for EDF.
But that's the crazy thing, is that we actually underestimated those numbers. That we were actually conservative in what we put on the box for this airplane.
I'd say that's true, yep.
With that said, 17 minutes. That's it. 20 minutes.
All right. Ready? This is the true test. LVC coming up. Battery kill our path.
How did... With a full speed pass at the end. Down to 21 minutes almost.
Yeah.
20:55, we'll call touchdown.
You know?
Ah, you should have told me. I could have stretched that glide. Right, get that GoPro. Get a camera. Just to show. Nothing changed. With the battery's going to be battery's on fire. Boom.
And this is the battery. You want to pull the battery out so we can see
not?
The size of it?
Let's prove that we're not cheating in any way, shape, or form. Verify. There's that out. Just to show. No throttle. It's dead. And the battery isn't like a football. Absolutely tepid. Nowhere near warm. 3% left. 20.14 volts.
Wow.
So, yeah. Not what we recommend. Try and keep your lipos above that. But this was all in aid of proving that we could. Minutes plus,
yep.
And I think we just about squeaked it. 21 minutes, 148 mile an hour, the E-Flite Havoc XE. Were you expecting that though?
No, I really wasn't. I thought we were just gonna catch those numbers by the razor's edge, honestly.
And the bad thing is, we've done all of this focus on how to smash those numbers. We haven't even touched on how great the aeroplane flies.
I know.
The more I fly it, the more it reminds me of
my hot rod version of my big Havoc.
Yeah.
It's almost like, I mean, I love my big Havoc, don't get me wrong, but there was times when I felt like I could do with a bit more speed, I could do with a little bit more zest, you know, a little bit of zip in it.
Yeah.
This is it.
Yeah.
This thing flies, like, does all the smooth aerobatic stuff like my big Havoc, but then when I want to go and go, you know what, I want to do a burner pass. Yeah, superb. Really, really good.
Yeah.
Would you own this Havoc XE over your other E-Flite aircraft, EDS, like the F4 or the Viper?
I think that the Viper is honestly probably going to get switched out. I love the Viper, don't get me wrong, but the Viper's a little bit more of a trainer, and yep, with the experience that I've been getting with EDFs, I think this is a little bit more my wheelhouse now.
Step up.
Yep. And I just enjoy the performance so much. This just has, you know, that 10%, 20% more over the Viper in about every aspect. So, yeah, I think this is probably going to take the place.
I don't think anyone ever got into jets to go slower, did they?
No, I don't think
if we're totally brutally honest. So I get what you're saying, and I look forward to seeing you flying one of these in the field fairly soon.
Awesome. Well, hey guys, thanks so much for joining us for this one. Come back, and we got a lot of other projects. We're actually going to shoot another episode right now.
It's summer. We're making the most of it. The office, although it's air conditioned, we prefer to be out in the field. So, yeah, we've got a lot of stuff cooking, a lot of events that we're hoping to cover. And yeah, stick with us, and we'll have more on the fly for you.
See you guys.